Hey guys, it's Dani. Alrighty, you know how I tell you that stressed orchids or setback orchids can produce tiny pseudobulbs until they recover from the stress or disease or getting adjusted to something? Well, did you ever wonder how tiny of a pseudobulb can an orchid produce? Well, let me just show you the champion. I have never seen tinier pseudobulbs than this, which were not seedlings. I am not sure if you're gonna recognize this. This is the Miltonidium pupukea sunset that Anna Maria sent me this summer, or actually last summer. I purchased it from a flower shop in Romania. The orchid didn't really have roots. It had a very bad infestation of spider mites along with the other orchids from that flower shop, and I treated it. But the whole stress took a toll on this orchid. Now she's doing okay, she loves semi-hydro, and I know you cannot see the roots, and she will be repotted. The pot is a little disgusting, but I had to monitor this orchid in a transparent pot. These are the new pseudobulbs. So this orchid was actually in bloom when Anna Maria got it. It is a mature orchid. It's not a big orchid to begin with, I'll give it that, but you can see the pseudobulb, let's say, is maybe a little bigger than an Oncidium twinkle. And this orchid can actually get a little bigger than this. Well, these are the new pseudobulbs. How big are they? Well, they're about 1 centimeter, and I think that's about 1/4 of an inch. Let me just show you next to my pinky finger. My pinky finger is a little bigger, and I really have tiny hands. So this is how tiny pseudobulbs can be on a stressed orchid. Nonetheless, this is good news because even these pseudobulbs can produce roots. They, however, cannot bloom. But in the state this orchid is, blooms are the last thing we want. They take up too much energy from the orchid, so it's okay. Look at this guy. My goodness, that is incredibly tiny. So yes, it is a miniature to medium-sized orchid to begin with, but these pseudobulbs are just the tiniest things I have ever seen on an orchid, which is not a seedling. It's a perfectly mature orchid. But as I was saying, it is a good news, and orchids which are very, very setback need to go through this. If this orchid would have had a few roots to begin with, or even a leaf, you can see the leaf is totally damaged by the spider mites. This is spider mite damage there. If the pseudobulb would have been a little bigger, it would have had a few more leaves to photosynthesize and even one little functional root. These pseudobulbs would have been bigger than this. But it was the worst case scenario. The orchid had infestations, the leaf was not functioning properly, there were no roots, and we only had one pseudobulb. And the result is this. But it's okay, it just means it's gonna take longer for the orchid to completely bounce back. But the news are good. The old pseudobulb is plump, the new pseudobulbs, even if tiny, they do have roots, and everything shall be okay within a few years. But it's reason enough to keep holding on to this orchid because it will be luscious and healthy and beautiful again, guaranteed. All we need is patience, and yeah, that's the sad part. Alrighty guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed this. You know the drill, rate this video below, subscribe for more orchid videos on a regular basis, and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. And with that said, I'll see you all next time. Bye!